Hello children, welcome to Math Park. Today we are going to learn about integers or directed numbers. Why it is necessary to learn integers? We have learned about various types of numbers. Integers are positive and negative numbers. When we go to cold regions, we find the temperature decreasing. So that is how we need to know about negative numbers. Integers are positive and negative integers. They can be shown on the number line. All the numbers on the right hand side of zero are called positive numbers. The numbers on left hand side of zero are called negative numbers. And zero is neither positive nor negative. To find the difference between a temperature of 2 degrees Celsius and a temperature of minus 4 degrees Celsius, we have to find the gap between these two numbers on the number line. So we move on to 2. To reach minus 4, how many places do we have to move? So we can see that we have to move 6 places to reach minus 4. That is how the difference between 2 degrees Celsius and minus 4 degrees Celsius is 6 degrees Celsius. Let us solve one more question. One day last spring, the temperature was 10 degrees Celsius. Overnight, it fell to minus 2 degrees Celsius. What is the difference in temperature? So from 10 to 0, it is 10. And from 0 to minus 2, it is 2. So the difference is 12 with a change of minus 12. The difference between two temperatures will always be a positive number. A change will be given as a negative number if the temperature falls or as a positive number if it rises. Let us learn addition and subtraction of integers using a number line. Use a number line to work out minus 3 plus 5. So minus 3 plus 5, on number line, we first move on to minus 3. When we have to add a positive integer, we'll have to move 5 places towards right. So moving 5 places towards right, we reach at 2. So that is how minus 3 plus 5 is 2. One more question, minus 1, minus 4. Now children, since we are adding a negative integer, we'll have to move 4 places to left from minus 1. So from minus 1, we start moving 4 places to left, we reach minus 5. So minus 1, minus 4 gives us minus 5. Let us understand the rules for adding and subtracting integers. So when we have to add minus 3 plus of plus 5, so we actually multiply this plus into plus, which gives plus. So we see that only one sign is left between two integers. So we now get here minus 3 plus 5. When one negative and one positive integer, we actually have to do the subtraction. 5 minus 3 is 2. And we give the sign of bigger number. So 5 is bigger here. So that is how 2 is positive. No sign is there. So that is a positive sign. Minus 3 plus minus 5. Plus into minus is minus. Two negative integers we add and give negative sign. So 3 plus 5, 8. And since both are negative, we get this as minus 8. Minus 3 minus plus 5. So the minus into plus gives minus. Again, we get here minus 3 minus 5. We add them. 3 plus 5 is 8. Since both of them are negative, we give the negative sign to the sum. So that is how it is minus 8. Minus 3 minus of minus 5. So minus into minus is plus. So minus 3 plus 5. Two different integers. One negative, one positive. We have to subtract. And we give the sign of a bigger one. So 5 minus 3 is 2. 5 is bigger, so that is how we get a positive sign over here. Let us solve one question. Minus 2 plus of minus 4. Now children, what we need to do here is, we need to open up this 2. Just imagine there is a bracket over here. So it's multiplication. So plus into minus gives minus. Now 2 negative integers we are supposed to add. So 2 plus 4 is 6. And that is how you get answer as minus 6. When we have to do on a number line, we move on to minus 2. And since it is a minus 4, we move 4 places to left. Moving 4 places to left, we get this as minus 6. So minus 2 minus 4 is minus 6. One more question. 1 minus minus 4. Again, we keep only one sign in between. Minus of minus is plus. So we get here 1 plus 4. And 1 plus 4, if I have to show on a number line, we move to 4. Since it is plus 4, we move 4 places towards right from 1. Moving 4 places towards right, we reach 5. So that is how 1 minus minus 4 gives us 5. Now I want children, you to pause this video and solve this question quickly. Yes. Very good. So minus of plus minus into plus gives minus, and minus 1, minus 3 is minus 4. Very good. Pat yourself if you got the correct answer. Let's move on to the next. Again, pause the video and solve this question. Okay. Minus 2 plus 6. 1 negative, 1 positive. From minus 2, we move 6 places to right, we reach 4. So that is how we get minus 2, minus of minus 6 is 4. Pat yourself again, those who got correct answer, very good. Keep practicing. Let us understand something new. Yes, absolute value of a number. Absolute value of a number is the distance of that number from 0 on a number line. So when we are talking of absolute value of minus 2, this symbol is called for absolute value, okay? Or we other ways we call it as a modulus of minus 2. So absolute value of minus 2, when we are talking, we are actually from 0, we are moving 2 places to reach minus 2. So 2 units. So that is how the absolute value of minus 2 is 2. If I have to find the absolute value of 56, from 0, I'll have to move towards 56. I have to count how many places I move there. So that is how I get absolute value of 56 as 56. Since it is a distance, children, and distance is never negative, the absolute value of a number is never negative. Let's understand multiplication and division of integers. So here are the rules for multiplication and division of integers. So when we multiply a positive integer by positive, we get a positive integer. Positive into negative, we get a negative integer. Negative into positive, we get a negative integer. And negative into negative, we get a positive integer. Look what same. We again start learning the division rules. Aren't they same? Yes. Positive into positive. Positive divided by positive is also positive. Positive integer divided by negative is negative. Negative divided by positive is negative. Negative divided by negative is positive. What do we see here? So whenever the signs are same, the answer is positive. And whenever the signs are different, the answer is negative. So it's easy, children. Multiplication and division, the rules are same. If two signs are same, the answer will be positive. If two signs are different, the answer will be negative. Come on, let's work out. Minus 2 into minus 4. Both of them have same sign. So the answer has to be positive. So that is how we get minus 2 into minus 4 as positive 8. Minus 3 into positive 8. Two different signs. Answer has to be negative. So that is how we get minus 3 into 8 as negative 24. Now, come on, pause. Pause your video and solve this quickly. Yes, it has to be negative. One positive, two different signs. And the answer is going to be minus 6. Come on, pat yourself for getting correct answer. Again, for one more question, just pause your video and solve this. Signs are same. So, yes, the answer has to be positive. So, we have minus 4 into minus 7 as positive 28. Excellent. Keep going. Keep practicing. Very good. Okay. Now, here we have little different. Okay. Just recall the laws of indices. Move on to my previous video on the laws of exponents, okay? So, minus 3 raised to 2 or minus 3 to the power 2. Here, minus 3 is called a base and 2 is called the index. So, what is to be done here? minus 3 is multiplied twice. So minus 3 into minus 3, again remember, same sign, the answer has to be positive. So we get the answer as 9. One more question. Minus 2 raised to 3. Recall again the laws of exponents. A negative base, the power is odd, the answer has to be negative. So here we multiply minus 2 3 times. So what do we do here? We first solve this first 2. Solving this minus into minus 2, 2 same signs, the answer has to be positive. So we get minus 2 into minus 2 as 4. And then 4 into minus 2, 1 positive, 1 negative, it has to be negative. So that is how we get the answer as minus 8. So minus 2 cube is minus 8. Very good, children. Keep practicing and subscribe if you haven't for new updates. Keep watching, keep practicing. Practice makes man perfect. Have a good day.